Alright, good evening, brothers and sisters. I-explain ko na naman sa inyo yung commonly asked question, Genesis 1:26, na sabi sa Biblia, "Let us make man in our image." Ito yung ginagamit ng iba na para i-prove that God is more than one person. But i-examine nating mabuti. Now, sabi ng mga Trinitarian, God said, "Let us make man in our image." Ang Diyos ay nagsasalita sa isang persona within the Godhead. But actually, that is still inconsistent with the Trinitarian point of view, because sabi nila, God is a Trinity. Then, if you apply that in the passage, if God is a Trinity, then in Genesis 1:26, sabi, "And God said." So, if God is a Trinity, then the Trinity said. That means that the Trinity is three persons, the three persons said. Mayroon pa bang kinakausap yung three persons? Dahil kung mayroon, then that would mean na there will be four, an additional God sa three persons. At the same time, hindi naman sinabi dyan, "And the Father said," but yung sabi sa Biblia, "And God said." So if God is a Trinity, then the Trinity must be talking to other persons, which I think they will not admit that kind of view. And then, the Bible is very clear na nung nilikha ng Diyos yung langit at ng lupa, siya lamang mag-isa yung lumikha. Siya lamang mag-isa yung naglalang. Isaiah 44 verse 24. "He alone," sa Tagalog, mag-isa, "spreadeth the earth by myself." Spreadeth the earth alone, or sa Tagalog, mag-isa. And the Bible is very clear that Deuteronomy 6:4, "There is only one God. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord." Isaiah 43 verses 10 to 11, "One God, none else." The Bible uses the term "none else," "none like me," "none beside me," "alone," "by myself." Those are emphatic oneness words. Yun yung ginamit ng Diyos. Hindi siya gumamit ng words na para i-describe ang kanyang plurality in persons, but He used oneness words in order for us to understand that He is alone, one, indivisible God na gumawa ng lahat ng bagay. Now, balikan natin yung Genesis 1:26. Bakit ang Diyos nagsabi ng "let us make man in our image"? Sabi ng iba, the word there is Elohim, plural. And then that's why pineransa ng it is paired with a plural pronoun, us. So, "let us make man" to prove that God is plural in persons. However, most of the Hebrew scholars nagsasabi that when they use word Elohim plural for God and use paired it with a plural pronoun, it is not to describe plurality of persons or that God is more than one person. But alam nyo, most of the scholars said that it speaks of plurality of majesty or plurality or multiplicity of attributes. In other words, God, it is intensifying the character of God. Ganon sila mag-describe sa Diyos. Pinoplural nila yung Diyos, hindi para i-pluralize yung person ng Diyos, but pinoplural nila yung character, attributes ng Diyos. God is love, God is wonderful, God is powerful. Pinoplural nila para ma-intensify nila kung gaano ka marvelous, gaano ka makapangyarihan yung Diyos. So, Genesis 1:26 is not to describe plurality of person, but plurality of majesty. That is the first explanation. 1:26 is talking about plurality of majesty. In fact, in verse 27, to prove na hindi plural yung Diyos, kung na-notice nyo, in verse 27, bumalik sa singular yung pronoun. Genesis 1:26, "let us make man," "let us make man in our image." But in verse 27, to prove that isa lang yung lumika, "let us make man in our image," sabi, "in the likeness of God," verse 27, "in the likeness," so God created man in His, singular, in His, singular pronoun, "in His own image." Male and female created He, singular pronoun, Him. "In the likeness of God created He, them." In verse 29, singular pronoun pa rin, He. 30 and 31. So, throughout the passage, makikita mo that only in verse 26 na plural yung pronoun na ginamit sa word na God. But throughout the succeeding or the subsequent verses, singular pronoun na yung ginamit. That means that it is not the intention of the writer to to prove the plurality of God, but only the plurality of attributes, or else sana naging consistent siya sa paggamit niya ng plural pronoun. But alam natin that in the very immediate next verse, so God created man in His own image. Now, to prove that only one God yung gumawa sa kay Adam, bumalik sa singular yung pronoun. And then we have Adam, the reflection of the God na gumawa sa kanya. He is one person, although Adam is composed of body, soul, and spirit, but still, hindi, walang magsasabi na si Adan ay tatlong persona. He is only one person, a reflection of the one God who created them. So that is the first explanation. Genesis 1:26 is not a plurality of person. It uses plural pronoun, but it is not a plurality of person. It's only describing the plurality of majesty or attributes of God. And now the second explanation is that, which is, ito yung palagi kong ginagamit pag may nagtanong, because I found it to be consistent with the biblical evidence and the Hebrew scholarship. God was talking to His angels. Ang Diyos ay nagsabi, nung sinabi niya, gawin natin o lalangin natin yung tao sa ating larawan, sa ating wangis o larawan. Hindi ang Diyos nakipag-usap sa ibang Diyos. Ang Diyos ay nakapag-usap sa mga anghel, because the angels were present at the time of creation. Job 38 verses 6 to 7, mababasa mo dyan, that the sons of God, when God created the universe, when God was in His creative days, when He showed His majestic power, the Bible says that the sons of God sang together, they shouted for joy. Nandoon sila, parang nag-cheer while nag-worship, while God was demonstrating His creative power. Nandoon yung mga angels. Now, another proof is in 1 Kings 22 verses 19 to 20, God also was talking to His angels. Sabi niya, who will persuade Ahab? Sino sa inyo yung mag-persuade sa kay Ahab? And then may sumagot yun na angel sa Panginoon. So God in His courtesy, although I believe that the angels were not part of the creation o hindi sila nag-contribute, but God in His courtesy, sabi ng ibang mga scholars, God in His courtesy, God in His kindness, He wants the angels to know about His creative work. So God was talking to His angels. Hindi siya nagsasabi sa ibang Diyos, because only one God, Malakay 2:10, isa lang yung nag-create sa atin. We have only one Father. And Isaiah 24:44, isang Diyos lang yung naglikha sa atin. So God was not talking to another God. Wala siyang kausap ni ibang Diyos, but he must be talking to His angels. That is the second view. The third view is that God counseled according to His own will. Ang Diyos nakikipag-usap sa kanyang sarili. Hindi ba minsan nakikipag-usap kasi yung sarili? You're just like your father. Parang ganito, parang pag sinabi mo na, let us see kung anong mangyayari mamaya. So, let us see. You use plural pronoun, but you know na ikaw lamang mag-isa. So, you are talking, you are deliberating to yourself. So, that is how God is. Let us see. Let us make man. Tingnan natin kung ano yung ating gagawin, although ikaw lamang mag-isa. Now, the verse of scripture is that in Ephesians 1:11, God maketh all things according to the counsel of His own will, according sa kanyang pag-deliberate sa kanyang sarili. So, if we can do that, God can do that, because in fact, we are just only a reflection of God. If God works all things according to the counsel of His own will, so tayo rin. That's why minsan sabi tayo, maligo tayo. Alam natin na ikaw lang mag-isa, or let us see what will happen. So that is the third explanation. Now the fourth is that it is a majestic or literary plural. In the book of, ito ginagamit palagi when you are in the part of a royalty, just like in the time of Daniel, in the time of Artaxerxes. Although isa lang yung nagsalita, but only one person yung nagsalita, but he described himself as plural most in the time, most of the time sa when you are a court or sa nasa palasyo ka, because it is a formal form of speaking. in the royal in royalty. For example, si Daniel nagsabi na we will tell thee the interpretation of king, we will tell thee, but we all know that it is only Daniel who interpreted the dream of King Nebuchadnezzar in Daniel 2:36. Artaxerxes, King Artaxerxes, sabi sa Ezra 4:18, the letter which he sent unto us hath been plainly read before me. In Ezra 7:13, Artaxerxes called himself I in one place. So here we have one person describing himself as we, just like Daniel, he described himself as we, but he is only one person. It is called majestic literary, majestic or literary plural. Okay? And the fifth, ito medyo mabigat-bigat ito na explanation, and I don't use this when I talk to new converts or mga bago lang sa church, or yung tao na hindi masyado malalim yung background niya sa Biblia. It speaks of God's foreknowledge of the future arrival of the Son. Nung sinabi ng Diyos na let us make man, He has in His mind, since God hindi siya kagaya natin na bound sa time, but He can look in the corridors of time. Nakita niya na yung Messiah in the future, or prophetically in His mind, nakita niya na si Jesus Christ, yung manifestation niya sa laman, the Son of God, nakita niya na. So He was referring to that Son na in the future na ma-crucify. So that's why sinabi niya, let us make man, having the Son of God or Jesus Christ in view in His mind. Although Jesus Christ is not yet existing, not pre-existing, but in His mind, the Messiah is already there. That's why sabi niya, let us make man in our image, having the Son of God in view. In Romans 4:17, God call it those things which be not as though they were. Hindi imposible yan sa Diyos, kasi yung mga bagay na wala pa, tinitingnan niya na parang nandoon na. At the same time, in Revelation 13 verse 8, the Lamb was slain before the foundation of the world. Kahit na yung tupa na si Jesus Christ ay wala pa, at saka ang sanlibutan wala pa, hindi pa na nagawa, hindi pa na create, but in the mind of God, yung si Jesus Christ was already crucified, not literally and physically, but prophetically in His mind. So that's why in 1:26, God was looking to the future arrival of the Son. That's why sabi, let us. He's referring to Jesus Christ, but not pre-existing, but prophetically. And that Jesus Christ in the fullness of time, the same Jesus Christ, is the incarnation of that one God. So again, first, plurality of majesty. Second, God was talking to His angels. Third, majestic, literary plural. Fourth is that God counseled according to His own will. And then last, God's foreknowledge of the future arrival of the Son. But I encourage yung workers natin na just use the explanation na basic. Ako, I use the basic explanation that God was talking to His angels, guys. Genesis 11 verse 2. That is the traditional Jewish point of view, that God was talking to His angels gaya in the time of the Tower of Babel. And sabi, let us go down to confound their language. I believe God was talking to His angels because angelic activity is very active in relation to God's dealing with man. So God bless you. Next time, I'm going to explain the deity and humanity of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.